So now I would like to bring to the podium, we have a few speakers here about this exciting initiative. And so first off, I'd like to bring forward Dr. Rodden Zent. He's the executive director of TTVN, the Texas A&M System's Interactive Communications Network that serves all system campuses. Rod took the lead in this effort and will explain more. Rod?
Well, today we celebrate a new era of communications connectivity for Texas A&M University Corpus Christi with the connection of broadband fiber to this campus. This university has been a leader in using technology to extend the boundaries of the campus. You know, I recall visiting here in the early 1990s when we first connected the campus, and I found a group of nurses toiling over some slow scan television equipment over regular phone lines to continue their nursing teaching to essential teaching for a tremendous need in workers in the healthcare field. That leadership has continued to this day, and since that time, the campus has embraced the rapidly changing lifestyles of our students. And all of these kids want immediate answers. They want things through their phones, their iPads, their laptops, and so it's been a challenge throughout the years. Well, today that same leadership is proud to announce the finalization of a project that will enable the campus to have really a superhighway to the internet world. The technology behind all of this is fiber optic cable, and the way to get it here was money. And that came when Corpus Christi IT leaders worked along with Texas A&M University System CIOs to compete for federal funds from the Broadband Technologies Opportunity Program created by the American Recovery and Reinvestment Act of 2009. Now, A&M Corpus Christi and the system CIOs put their support and their trust in TTVN, which is the network that connects and serves all the system campuses, and in Dr. Walt Magnuson, of course, who is the Director of Telecommunications at Texas A&M University, to write a grant that would fund fiber to each of our system campuses across the state. Now, to make a long story short, that grant, which was highly competitive, was awarded to TTVN in 2010. We received $6.5 million in federal funds, and we matched that with about $1.5 million in TTVN reserves from our system campuses and through a generous $1.5 million private-public partnership with telephone companies and local cities. Today, we mark the connection to that fiber to this campus. What really does this mean? The fiber optic cable gives this island campus sort of a super highway to the internet. Much like many of the larger campuses on any of our coasts, this campus now stands in that lane. The new 10 gigabit per second circuit provides more than adequate bandwidth to serve all of the administrative, academic, and research needs of the campus for years to come. And the future is very, very bright. But the actual fiber capacity is easily changed. We can take that 10 times more simply by changing the electronics. So what that means is no new expensive construction is needed. Thus, the cost is contained because we own the fiber. It means that cost-effective bandwidth is available now and in the future for classes using high-definition video conferencing, research projects that need to move terabytes of data from campuses to supercomputer centers, and for students to access materials easily from computers and smartphones and tablets. Now, you'll be hearing today from a number of people who made all of this possible. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Zent. Now let me introduce Dr. Walt Magnuson. He's the Director for Telecommunications at Texas A&M University, who wrote the grant that designed the fiber construction plan, and most importantly, developed the relationship with the local telephone companies who provided the necessary matching funds and partnerships to enable us to receive this funding. Dr. Magnuson?
Please. Thanks. I'm Dr. Walt Magnuson. I had the oversight and responsibility of oversight and completion of the project itself. That included contract negotiations and construction. I was telling Chancellor Sharp on the way down here, this is in the 30 years that I've been doing this, this has been the most challenging project I've ever done, but really the most rewarding. Project began with a grant request to the United States Department of Commerce, as Dr. Zent had mentioned already, to the NTIA. And the grant was only possible due to the support of our partners, including the City of Corpus Christi, Valley Telephone, who's represented here. These partners provided partial cost match, existing infrastructure, and even manpower in the case of the city. We had some of David's construction folks working with us in terms of actually building the glass. Other presenters are going to talk about what this grant did. I'd like to spend a few minutes about talking about why this is important. In 1996, the United States Congress passed the Telecommunications Reform Act, which in part began to deregulate the telephone industry in the United States. As of that day, the telephone company that your mother and my mother knew when they were growing up no longer existed. The intent of the act was to promote competition in the industry, which in many areas it has. There has been, however, one negative side effect of the way that we do, way that the industry is operated today. And that negative side effect has basically been that investment in infrastructure has suffered dramatically. Certain parts of what we could count on the carriers to provide for us in the past, we're now having to start to do ourselves. The best example of this, of the type of infrastructure, is terrestrial infrastructure, which is mainly, as Rod said, fiber optic cable. Earlier this year, the FCC prioritized funding infrastructure in rural underserved areas. That was in recognition of the fact that private-public partnerships are the only way that we could stop this infrastructure investment death spiral. The BTOP grant that we're here today to celebrate is built on the concept of community anchor institutions. Anchor institutions in the Corpus Christi area include Cal Allen Fire Station No. 2, Northwest Senior Citizen Center, Garcia Arts and Education Center, the Art Museum, and of course the Texas A&M University Corpus Christi, and Regional Service Center No. 2. So we've reached out to K-12 as well. So now that we've completed the grant, what's next? Since infrastructure, which I know y'all don't want to hear, since infrastructure is a never-ending process, the next logical step would be to regionalize the efforts. By doing this, the investment that we have made, and when I say we, it's the federal government and the City of Corpus Christi and the A&M system, by doing this, the investment we've made in this area could be leveraged to include surrounding communities, making you the future anchor institution going forward. Corpus Christi is a regional city. Your hospitals, stores, services, colleges, and everything around you thrive. When the cities and communities around you thrive, the City of Corpus Christi thrives as well. With the changing landscape in the telecommunications industry, the City of Corpus Christi and A&M Corpus Christi have embraced the reality that if we don't do this kind of stuff ourselves, working with private industry as a partner, no one else is going to do this for us. The vision that Mayor Nelda Martinez and the City Council have shown, the leadership that Mike Armstrong, David Trujillo have provided, and the partnership that's provided with Marcus and Mirta here from Valley Telephone today have made this a reality. Were it not for the professionals in Corpus Christi, the project would never have happened. This celebration should not be viewed as the end of a job well done, but more as the beginning of better things to come. Thank you.
And now I'd like to bring up Michael Armstrong. He's Director of Municipal Information Systems with the City of Corpus Christi to share the role of the city.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for allowing us to be here today. Thank you for allowing us to participate in this project. It was good for the university, certainly, and it was good for the city. Corpus Christi has been building fiber optic networks since about 2003. We currently have 107 buildings connected to our local net, and now we're adding certainly the university and through that the other campuses. We also have the second largest wireless network in the United States. We cover 144 square miles with Wi-Fi service, and it's strangely become more of a community amenity than anything else. People really like it when they come here. During this project, the city's contribution was in cash and in in-kind contribution was around $650,000. And for that, we get connectivity to an additional 10 facilities. And the real value of that is that it freed up our resources to concentrate on other areas of the city. We are continuing to build, and we will continue to look at partnerships. I think we have plans, as David Trevino said to me earlier this morning, to build another 100,000 feet of fiber over the next 2 years. So the city is very well wired. We are much more famous outside the city than we are in for the work that we've done. And we want to continue to do that. And part of that work going forward is the continued partnership with Texas A&M. We have some things that Terry and I have talked about that we'll be working on. And it's simply an extension of a partnership that existed for a while. And I think this is our participation together simply made that stronger. And we look forward to continuing that. And thank you all.
Now I'd like to bring forward Terry Tatum. He's Associate Vice President for Information Technology and our Chief Information Officer here at Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Terry.
Thank you. I would first like to acknowledge Mark Stone, the Texas A&M System Chief Information Officer. He was not able to join us here today, but he has supported the Texas A&M system, working with public-private partnerships, resulting in high-speed internet connectivity access to all of the A&M system universities and health science center. I want to briefly cover the technical advances we're celebrating here today. The advances are first, increased internet capacity for the university. Second, faster speeds, and third, better reliability. The network is better because we've gone from 1 gigabit to 10 gigabits. We can now handle 10 times the volume of information across the network. It's also a lower latency, and that is a significant benefit. Latency is the amount of time it takes for a bit of data to get from one place to the other. Both capacity and speed are very important for good quality internet. Reliability has also been improved because we now have two connections to the internet, so data keeps flowing even if one connection goes down. All of this greatly benefits A&M Corpus Christi by helping faculty do their jobs, students do their work, and it's essential for researchers to have this kind of connectivity. This will not only help our current researchers, it will help the university in recruiting researchers in the future. And best of all, with thanks to TTVN and the Texas A&M system, this comes with few additional costs for the university.
Thanks, Terry. Few additional costs, that's always good. At this time now, I'd like to introduce our President and CEO of Texas A&M Corpus Christi, Dr. Flavius Killebrew.
It's always interesting when a CIO tells you with fewer costs. So thanks to everybody for being here today on this very special completion of this vital project. We all depend on very fast and reliable internet connection, and now we have something that's 10 times faster than we had before, the fastest in South Texas. This capacity puts the campus technologically on par with some of the largest universities in the United States, more than 10 times that of any campus in the A&M system other than College Station. None of this would have been possible without this partnership between the A&M system, the federal government, and the City of Corpus Christi, and our telephone partners. Thank you, Chancellor Sharp, and your team for your leadership and initiative in securing the federal matching funds for this valuable project. We're lucky to be able to tap into an already strong and existing fiber optic network in use by the City of Corpus Christi. That partnership greatly extended the impacts and benefits of this project. We here at the Island University are committed to these types of partnerships, partnerships that enhance the community as a whole. We're on a path to an emerging research status, and that means an increase in the amount of research and scholarly activity across all fields. And that type of research often requires advanced computing powers. We have with us today Dr. Chun Tao Lu, one of our many researchers at the Island University, and I'd encourage you to talk to Dr. Lu and hear more about how faster, better, stronger connections are making their research easier. This kind of research at the Island University is just a start. We're raising the bar to bring in more research funding, additional high-quality professors, and more doctoral students to raise the level of research coming from A&M Corpus Christi. This is the kind of synergy that will propel forward the Island University, Corpus Christi, and the entire Coastal Bend. Thanks for this fantastic partnership, and to each of you for your commitment improving education across the state of Texas. Now let's hear from Chancellor Sharp and the Texas A&M University system.
Well, I asked Flavius what he wanted me to talk about, and he said, I think you should talk about 2 minutes, and so I did that. I'm here simply to say thank you to the folks on the front row and the people that you represent for what has been a truly remarkable project that has produced for the A&M system the best connectivity that exists in the state of Texas. The difference it has made from Texarkana to Canyon to Laredo and every place else is absolutely remarkable. It is especially important for this university, not because this university was better or worse in connectivity, but because this university here is making such great strides with regard to research. And research tends to eat up bandwidth, and it tends to eat up a lot of capacity. And this institution here is going to be one of the really great research institutions in the state of Texas, and it's going to need one heck of a lot of juice in order to, for some reason, those type professors really play long and hard hours with the internet. And so this has really been a great town and gown relationship too, because not only through the system and through the universities, and then the universities contact and contract through the communities, and so the community of Canyon, the community of Texarkana, Corpus Christi, Laredo, all over the place, everybody winds up a winner in this process, and it allows us to say that no one is better connected than the Texas A&M University system and the internet. Thank you all for being a part of that. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Chancellor. Thank you. I'd like to thank everyone for being here to celebrate this achievement today. And what we're going to do now is we're going to turn it on.
Ready?
Okay.
Ready?
You can count it down now.
1, 2, 3.
Thank you all for being here today. Please feel free to interview any of these.